35, there it goes, 40, 35, 30.
What's up, everybody? How you doing? This is Tyler Lockett with the Lock It Up Show, and we are here with B-Jack. Man, how you doing, man?
Doing good, man. Doing good.
All right, how's everything going with you? How's the season going with you? How's life outside of football going?
Season's progression. Life outside of football is doing really well.
What's some of the things that you do outside of football?
Man, the majority of my time get taken up with my dog. So I'm not here. I got my little Frenchie, and we everywhere. You know, so.
Okay, that's the first dog you ever had?
Absolutely not. I had like a kennel going on in college. that was my side hustle. I used to get paid to train people's dogs. So I always had a house full of dogs, and now I just got one.
What's your dog's name?
Giovanni, man.
Giovanni?
Yeah, the one and only, Giovanni St. Jackson.
What made you name your dog Giovanni?
If you look at him, he just looked like that would be his name. Like if he was a human, I'm trying to tell you, if he was a human, bro, he'd be a light-skinned guy, the real pretty boy. His name would be Giovanni, real smooth talking fella.
Okay. Now, if y'all don't know, B-Jack is the type of person that likes to dress up in style, likes to show different type of fashion. And what you might not know is he likes to dress up his dog too. You wanna talk a little bit about that? Did you buy him some J's?
Yeah, I did, man.
He bought his dog some J's.
So my dog, he's like my son. I like to, the French Bulldog breed, they got a lot of health problems. So with all the rain in Seattle, it started with that, and I ended up putting some sweatshirts on them, sweatpants, and then I found out there's a lot of dog vendors who make a lot of clothes that resemble clothes that you would wear. So if we're going out and it's raining, then I put a coat on them. If we're going out in town, like if we're going to the airport or going somewhere, then usually I'll have them match me. And you know, right now we're working on the shoes, so I did get up some J's.
There were
some
working on a shoe. Okay.
The baby shoes, man, you know, a lot of babies are wearing them. My dog can wear them. He don't like them as much though, so. It's gonna be a while before you wear them comfortable.
All right, so you from Dallas, right?
No, I'm from Pittsburgh. So everybody think I'm from Dallas.
But why do you like Dallas so much?
I think that was like the first major city that I just kind of fell in love in. Going to school in Lubbock, it was the closest major city. We went down there, and a lot of my close friends from school lived there, so I think that's more what it is. When I go there, I feel comfortable because everybody I play football with still lives there, and I make connections through tech. So, I mean, top of the weather and everything else.
Oh yeah, I feel that. So, have you ever went to the amusement park?
Yeah.
Out there in Dallas?
Yeah, which one?
What's it called?
I can't Six Flags.
Six Flags.
You've been to Six Flags? Yeah, I went to Six Flags. That was really disappointing, man.
Really?
Yeah. Funnel cakes were amazing. Loaded with ice cream,
you
chocolate syrup.
You would be talking about eating.
It was so delicious, bro. But the thing is, I couldn't ride anything. I could only ride a step, but my feet were dangling. I was too tall. It was weird. Oh. And I've been to amusement parks. I ride everything else, but they don't make them too big and at that one, so I'm disappointed.
Yeah, I don't really have that problem. I'm trying to make the mark. Usually I don't make the mark because I'm too short.
So look, it works in your benefit. You either ride the Superman and all that stuff, and I'll just sit over there on my funnel cake and gain weight.
All right, so look, for the next touchdown celebration, what's something that we should do? We want you to be able to create it. If you could create any type of touchdown celebration, what would it be? And are you willing to show them?
I already pitched this to you. I'm telling you, it's a good one. So it'll be you. You catch a touchdown from Russ. It'll be you and Demo. So you'll slap Demo. Boom, he falls. You stand over him, give him a little fake kick, and you run, jump over him, you bounce off the rope. And on the corner over there, you'll see JB and DK. You bounce, jump over, bump over the rope. They'll both be trying to act like they're getting tagged in. But you'll bump, jump over, and then you'll do the people's elbow. And then you'll go to pin him. Russ will come in and slide like a dramatic referee. And one, two, and right before three, DK will jump in and break it up. And then, yeah, it's like a wrestling match. Stole it from
so
the
So how many seconds would that take?
Like 15. If everyone's in the same area, we got to run like, I don't know, like whatever concept that everybody could be in the same area. So Russ is the only one coming in late.
Okay, so we got to figure out if we got a timeout. So we can be able to call a timeout so we don't get in trouble on the extra point.
Well, you know what? With all the toe drags you've been doing, they're usually reviewing them anyway. So you got a little extra time. While they're making sure and confirming that it's a touchdown, we got some time there.
Well, whether I score or whether somebody else scores, I think that's something that we would definitely take into consideration. Thank you for being on the show.
I appreciate
you. Hope you had a good time. Thank y'all for listening to me and B-Jack as we talk about Giovanni. as we talk about why he likes being in Texas so much, why Texas Tech never beat Kansas State when I was there.
We never talk about that. It's not a truth.
Now we're teammates. So we can be able to enjoy and celebrate this game that we love, as well as celebrate each and every one of you that's watching. Thank you.